Good evening. My name is Akinola Owolabi. We are indeed apologetic, starting a little behind schedule. It was due to technical problems. When we were about starting, you will have seen that the montage was already played. Then, Power Surge came, and we had to apply a break. Once again, accept our apology for that. Today, we have a big fish in the house. One we can call our own, who was here at a stage you can call the stage of the Osun State Broadcasting Corporation. He was a board member, and from there became the deputy governor of this dear state of ours. A lawyer by profession, but I want to say a politician by vocation. Today is the leader or the coordinator of Yoruba Palm Social Cultural Group Afeniferi in the state of Osun. Join me in welcoming Soko Adeleke Adewoyi as our guest on Let's Discuss Today. Oba, you welcome on the program.
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. I'm happy to be back again. Thank you for reminding me my time here when this place was in the process of being set up. And thank you for even appreciating my contribution, not only my own contribution, the contribution of the entire board at that time. Thank you very much.
Once again, you're welcome, sir.
Yeah.
Let's start this way. We talk a lot about Afeniferi, but that is why we are here.
Thank you.
Well, starting from the familiar terrain, when you look at the media today, compared to where you are actively involved in terms of management, in terms of what was happening, a lot of things have been said about the media, condemning them, saying they are doing well. When you look at this democracy, the role of the media in propagating the ideas, the norms of democracy, how will you rate the media succinctly?
Well, excellent, so to say. Excellent. Time changes. The media in the early period, say like 50s, 60s, was not as it is today. You have to be very frank. In those days, the media were concerned to get, support the politician to get independent freedom for Nigeria. But now, we're already a freed country. So, the media has been playing excellent role. What are their roles? Educate the public, criticize where necessary, let the public know what the government is doing. And of course, this is not an easy task. Sometimes they, express their opinion, which is not acceptable to the government. They are, sort of, either some of them have been maybe punished for writing what is true. So, unlike in those days, their main concern at that time is to criticize the British something or whatever and obtain independence. But we are already independent. There are a lot of problems Nigeria is facing. Security, education, social welfare, in roads, uncountable. The media has to be on their toe. What is the government doing about this? What is this? They sometimes suggest is what the government should do, or even criticize them. So, And if you look at the educational background of media today, quite different to what it was yesterday.
Okay, sir. Now, looking at the state of Osun, where you had once had opportunity of being the second in command in terms of the administration of the state, the development of the state, is it measuring up to your expectation as a person?
Yes, it is. When a child is born, except there's a problem of the medical disabilities, the child will grow. Also has grown. In fact, in the last 10 years, or 15 years, I'm very proud to be an Osun man. It's an understatement to say that we are not growing at all. We have gone very far. Look at your institution here, your television house. It was not like this 10, 15 years back. It was just like an embryo. Manage this, manage all something. But you are now of international standard now, if one can say. The same thing with the government itself. You know, we have advanced tremendously in Osun State. Though we have some problems. And these problems are not of our own making. The problem in Osun is also the problem of all other states in Nigeria. What are the problems? One, lack of sufficient infrastructures, security, lack of money, not sufficient money. Two, maintain the government. Here, workers are still being paid, though we thank God that they have been paid fully, receiving their full salary now, but I mean, a year or two back, it was half salary. It was not good for administration of any administration, but thank God we are getting over that. But there are still problems there. Some workers are still complaining, though, particularly those who are retired. I understand some of them, not all of them, have not received their something. And government is doing all it can to make sure that these people are satisfied. So, also generally, we are making progress. Look at the development in Oshogbo. It was not like this 12, 15 years back. Somebody described Osogbo at that time as a glorified village capital. There was no sufficient water running, no good roads, nothing. But we are. They develop educationally. We have got universities here now. The charity institutions, speaking of both private and public. So, we have to thank God. Osun is making progress.
Okay, Osun is making progress. We'll still come talk about Osun. Yeah. We'll talk about Nigeria in the course of this program. But let's go straight to Afeniferi. Yes. How would you describe Afeniferi today?
Afeniferi, let's start by what is Afeniferi? We have to know what it is.
Okay.
Afeniferi is, was and is, still is, association founded by Chief Obafemi Awolowo. The spirit behind that, he called it Afeniferi. It was later we had Ilosiwaju, Ebe Ilosiwaju Yoruba, that is the progressive Yoruba. We know, we remember, we know the pattern of government of Chief Aguru, excellent. What are the things he brought to Yoruba land? There are many, I don't need to be explaining it here. First of all, free education, industrialization, setting up institutions for learning, educating the public. Those are the good things Awolowo was set up that made the followers after his demise that this association known as Afenifere should continue. But don't let me digress whatever is happening today. As far as we are concerned, Afenifere Yoruba is perfectly in order.
Okay. I asked that question in view of the relevance of Afenifere politically and otherwise in those days when it was set up in the 50s.
Yes.
Later, during the struggle for the enthronement of democracy and struggle against the military, it used to be a very strong, very united body.
Yeah.
Today, it's Afenifere still as intact, as relevant, as pushful, socially, culturally, politically, as it used to be?
My answer is yes to all the questions or the sub-questions you are asking. But it requires some explanation.
Okay, let's have the explanations.
As it is, you will now, you media men will conclude that Afenifere has been polarized. One side, one group on one side, another group on the other side. It used to be one voice, who says. But when some renegade, people who believes in themselves and themselves alone, enter the group, it seems to have divisive tendencies. If you don't say, you don't join what they are saying, they tag you as an enemy. I'm not here to mention any names, but you media know what's exactly happening. Our position now is we want to achieve for Yoruba area what Chief Aguru have been preaching. That is sound education, sound system of government, industrialization, security for our people, and political advancement of Yoruba people in the context of Nigeria. That is what the present Afenifere, which I belong, is pursuing. And how do we achieve that? We have been achieving. If you have to, you know, a lot of things have been going on with some Yoruba people, some Katikan people will not give kudos to it. Osibajo is now the vice president. He's a member of the APC as well. He's staunch supporter of Afenifere. The aims and objective of Afenifere is gradually being accepted at the federal level. You want restructuring, that process on. You want police, I mean, what we call local police. We are almost achieving that. We want better wages for our workers. We are almost getting that. We want our children to have free education. It's almost introduced to proud Nigeria now. Those are the things which Afenifere stood for.
Okay, okay. Afenifere gave birth to an action group in those days, pre-independence Nigeria. You can say almost the same thing with the Unity Party of Nigeria, UPN, of Obafemi Awolowo. And when we were returning to democratic rule, 1998-99, people would say, yes, Afenifere did a lot in the birth of the Alliance for Democracy. And in those days when you talk about these parties, it's like talking about Afenifere. And if you talk about Afenifere, it's like talking about those parties. Today, as far as APC, PDP and other parties are concerned, is there a party that we can say, yes, we talk about that party, it's like talking about Afenifere, or if you talk about Afenifere, it's synonymous with that party. Do we have?
Yes. The APC is a child of Afenifere.
Really?
Yes. The other Afenifere, they are byproducts of PDP. They won't dispute that. They have shown during the last election, or preparatory to the last election, they were against any talk of Maja, of any Yoruba group, with anything to do with the North. You've read it. Whereas they are hobnobbing with Jonathan and the PDP. We now say, is this what Chief Awolowo set down for us to do? The answer is no. APC is, Afenifere is part of APC. It's, APC, as you know, is a collection of so many associations, political associations that formed the APC. And Afenifere, as it was then during the earlier stage of the formation, played a prominent role. So we cannot divorce Afenifere from the APC now. We will let people know that the Afenifere of which we are is part and parcel of APC.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. There is this proverb.
Whereas the other group, Adebanjo and others, didn't want to do, has nothing to do with APC. They are for PDP.
Okay. There is a Yoruba proverb that will say, yes, you meet the elderly in the closet.
Yes.
Okay. And there was a point in time in the early part of this civil rule or democracy, as we want to put it, that people were conversing. Why can't Afenifere devoid itself of anything politics? So that it will be an umbrella body for anybody and everybody in Yoruba land. Is it possible for Afenifere to be less political or apolitical?
Well, it's a good suggestion if you say Afenifere should be something different to political. But the situation in Nigeria is not as such, it's not. If Afenifere, the idea is for Afenifere to remain apolitical.
Okay.
That's the idea. We are all human beings. It is during the time of Chief Awolo, by his leadership quality, that sort of things could happen. There is no any prominent Yoruba man there that's not have any inclination to either PDP or APC. And then, if you say they should join FDFERE, you know, it may not work. But we are coming together, right? I know within the next 1 or 2 years, there's going to be a unification of FDFERE.
Okay, that is a good one. Mm. That's a good one. Well, but before the unification will come, what exactly are the points that brought about this division into fascism and fashion? Fascism means fashion in of FDFERE. There must be some other currents, otherwise we wouldn't be having these factions.
Well, it's just I don't want to say sometimes it's personality personality mistrust.
Okay.
Personality competition.
Okay.
I'm better than you.
Okay.
No, you are not better than me. First, if we want an adequate answer to that, we'll have to go back at the period of adjusting.
Okay.
Which may take a longer time to explain. Adjusting after the demise of Chief Awolowo, adjusting took the mantle and was widely acclaimed to be the leader of FDFERE. After his demise now, Baba Adesanya took over. Right? Mm-hmm. Kudos to him. At the time he took over, it was time, very difficult time for Yoruba people and FDFERE in particular. That was when Abacha was there. Abiola was elected as the president. Abacha refused to swear in him. And FDFERE took the struggle and formed what is then known as NADECO. The struggle was well fought. But of course, after some struggle, when the aims were not achieved, disloyalty creeping, blame against one another was said. That was the genesis of the breakup of FDFERE into two factions. Fasorunti, from my understanding, is an usurper. He was not at any given meeting chosen as the leader of FDFERE. The group that supported him has their hidden agenda. Now, good thing Bola Tinubu rose up. He fought like a good Yoruba man would fight for the actualization of the June 12th. For this, he earned a rebuke from some of the leaders who were playing hide and seek game. If dying with Abacha in the night, and in the day, we start condemning him. We realized this and we knew that that was not a better approach to actualize Yoruba aspirations, aims and aspirations. That was just, in a nutshell, the background to the divisions. The background is still there. I mean, the division is still there. In the sense that we said we want to have a say in the government of Nigeria. Osibajo is now the best vice president. The better thing is to support him. Give him the necessary, you know, advice, not condemning him and all the rest of it. And he's achieving. The man is achieving. So these people who are saying Afenifere, this and that, they have their own political something. They want somebody else to be their leader, their own leader of Nigeria. Obasanjo was there for 8 years. We gave him tremendous support. What did he do? Nothing.
Okay, there was a point in time that you have Afenifere regional group. What was renewed then in the real sense of it?
Well, I'm not a member of the regional group, but what I learned from there is during the crisis, they found that our leaders at that time, they were not carrying out, they are not being truthful, they are not being straightforward, and they were not carrying, they are not propagating Yoruba ideas and what Yoruba is standing for or stood for. So they were a group of young men. The only difference is their ideological, they have their ideology, the way of approach, which the elderly people may not necessarily, they agree with them, but they want one step and then another. Those are just the difference. But if you know a group now, has come back to the main fold. I can assure you that.
Okay. In Yoruba land, with due respect to Baba, they say when you have an elderly person in the marketplace,
yes,
and you see a woman backing her child, and the child's neck is bending, the elderly one will try to adjust. Also, the Yorubas will say, when you have infernal, where you go to pick mud to quench it, fire should not start there.
Yes.
You look at the Afenifere. These are the leaders in their own right in Yoruba land.
Yeah.
These are the group that every other group should run to when there are problems. Now, when you now have misunderstanding between them, what does that say of the race?
If I will say there's misunderstanding,
it's just the if there's no misunderstanding, would there have been division, sir?
Well, in everything, within even in a family, there may be a problem. We are. There's a division within the family. Okay. One side will agree on this one, the other side will agree on that. I don't want us to emphasize on the disagreement. It's the way of approach. This, we all want good things for Yoruba land.
Okay.
But approach now is the question. Whereas some people are saying that is not a joining forces or joining hands with our brothers in the northern part. It's not an ideal situation. The other side is saying, we are saying that unless you are part and parcel of the government at the center, most of these things we want to achieve may be unachievable. And we have proof that now we are achieving gradually. Our universities are being improved. Our roads are being improved, railways are coming, all those things, they were not there before. So I want to say that it's the approach that is the main thing there, not the person. When they will say approach, you have to talk about personalities also. There are some people who can manage better than others. Whereas some people, they only make noise. When they are there, nothing. They associated themselves with Jonathan for good 6 years he was in government. What are the achievements? Nothing. I want them to come and tell us when they were with Jonathan, this is what they achieved for the overland. No.
Okay.
Look at the appointment under Jonathan. They are now criticizing appointment under Buhari. If you look at a figure published sometimes ago, Yoruba has achieved tremendously. The chief of staff of Jonathan, Igbo, this, Igbo, that, Igbo, this. This one, they are not serious.
Okay, sir. In those days, yeah, when Afedifere will speak, the whole country will vibrate. Yes. In fact, the fear of Afedifere was wisdom to so many other sections of Nigeria. Today, when faction A will speak and faction B will speak, do we still have that kind of respect, that kind of aura attending the position of Afedifere at the national level?
Yes, of course, we have. We have personalities like Kibo, Baba Tinubu, Baba Bisi Akande, Ayo Fasoni, and heaps of others. These are good Yoruba people. They know where they are coming from. They know where they are going. And they are walking towards it. In those days when you said, when I very, very speaks, it shakes the political atmosphere. At that time, we were in a very unstable situation. We were struggling. And it's natural. When you are fighting for something, you make noise. But now, we are in government. Afedifere is in government. I'm proud to say that.
Okay, and that is why we have relative silence.
we are making, we are not silent as such.
I say relative. Relative silence.
Look at
silence.
This question of security.
Okay.
Afedifere as a group went as far as to meet Jonathan Amem, Buhari, President Buhari, who gave them good audience. These are what we
hello.
That is happening.
Let's check our discussion. Hello.
Hello, sir.
Good evening. Okay, let's concede to you. Sọ nǹkan kan fún yín, a ní oríṣiríṣi ètò tó jẹ́ ti Ìgbò, tó jẹ́ ti Yorùbá. Ètò tá à ń ṣe lọ́wọ́lọ́wọ́ ti Yorùbá ẹ wà tá à ń pè ní Kajọsọ. So a lè fi gbogbo ẹ farabalẹ̀, a lè fi gbogbo ètò iléeṣẹ́ ká fi ṣe èdè kan. Kì í ṣe Yorùbá nìkan náà ń gbọ́ wa, wọ́n ń gbọ́ wa tó fi dórílẹ̀-èdè Amẹ́ríkà. Ẹ sọ tẹ́ ẹ bá fẹ́ sọ.
Baba
Baba Baba
Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba Baba
please.
My name is Muntala.
You're welcome. You're welcome. Welcome. You listen to him now. We should remove political dimension from our Fenifere. We had asked that. Maybe you want to answer him in Yoruba, since he asked in Yoruba. We aligned that for the first time on this program, but you can do that.
Omo Yoruba ponbele lebi na je pe boya mo so ede amulumala ebi na mo fe so gesi ba awon gese lo ni gesi ni ka koko so na mo gbe gugu kan ti e so iyen ni wi pe ki a ma fi oro oselu bo afenifere bo ye ko ri niyan sugbon awon jeburu jera kan won o le se kon ma fi oselu bo oselu ti afenifere ti wa nse oselu to le mu lo siwaju ba le Yoruba ni alati ma lakaka ibi nkan ti Yoruba pe ka le mu se ta ba fara mo ijoba to wa loke.
Hello, yes sir.
Hello,
good evening.
Good evening,
sir. Yes, can we have you? Please go ahead. What's your name?
Please, I'm a Yoruba man living at Osogbo. I just want to ask a question for our...
Go ahead, ask your question, please.
The question is this. If they are calling themselves a Yoruba leader, they are not supposed to take part in any party. But Adama has said something now.
No Yoruba leader is fighting for himself.
Okay.
If the ideal or the idea of Afenifere is to bring progress to Yoruba land, it's not for their family.
Okay.
It's for the generation of Yoruba people.
Yoruba race.
So I don't want us to be saying they are fighting for themselves. What are they fighting for? What is Ayo Fasemi fighting at that age for himself?
Okay. Hello?
No, it's for the generation of Yoruba people.
Hello?
Hello?
Who is on the line, please? Can we have him? Okay, we lost that call. And it sounds like a female voice. Okay. Progressing from that, the meeting of Afenifere. Hello? Hello? Hello, good evening. Please, can you speak a bit louder?
Oh, okay. My name is Joshua, calling from Lagos State, Lekki.
Lekki, okay.
Okay, sir. My question is just a simple question.
Okay. The first one again, sir.
Hello,
sir.
Okay.
There are benefits to coming generation. Okay.
Number two is that the ongoing rivalry between Fulani and the state. Killing your back to the when you are only going to go to the boss to us.
Can you react to Lawson's from Lekki, Lagos? The first one. the benefits of what will the coming generation be benefiting from Afeniferi, and the issue of security, which we had spoken about in passing. Can you attend to that?
That is the benefit. That's why I said it is not practicable to say, because we are Afeniferi, we cannot have a say in government.
Okay.
If you do that, we just sit down in our panel and begin to make noise. Unless you join where the policy is being implemented. And look at what is happening now.
Okay.
Agriculture is being improved. Education is being improved. Right? Rome is not built in a day. We all understand that.
Okay. Now, to security, like I asked earlier, security. People believe that Afeniferi kept silent for a bit.
No,
you said you went to Mr. President.
Yes.
Lossing from Lekki is asking, yes, in concrete terms,
yes,
what have you done?
When we saw or noticed the damages this so-called Fulani has done, the generality of the people, insecurity, and fear of even people traveling from one place to the other, we took the matter to Aso Rock, or whatever they call it, and let Buhari realize and put more emphasis on security, particularly Southwest.
Did you get any commitment from him?
Yes. He got, if you go between Ibadan and Ife now, you see contingent of police, army, customs everywhere. That attack at the Yob soldiers come down a little bit. That is the what Afeniferi is doing.
Okay, let me add this to it. This idea of creating whether colony, whether rural grazing area or whatever in Nigeria is taking off in some states in the north. What is the position of Afeniferi on this matter?
No, Afeniferi does not support that idea.
Afeniferi would not allow lands in Yoruba lands to be given out as cattle colonies or whatever?
Yes, I can certainly say that. Afeniferi, you know, Fulani people have been rearing cows here without allocating any lands to them. Right? And that has never been a problem. Most of the cows which they rear are even owned by our people. They buy the cows in stock, employ Fulani to rear them, to feed them.
No real land for
Yoruba land.
Okay.
That. We are close to that. Unlike
Hello, good evening.
Good evening.
Quickly, can we have you?
My name is Shiloza.
Okay.
I wanted to ask the leader of Afeniferi.
Yes, ask your question.
Hello, sir.
Ask your question, please.
Okay, sir. Those leaders, are they chosen by the group or they have been here as political Afeniferi?
Okay. How do you become a member of Afeniferi? And how does Afeniferi leader, how did they emerge?
Okay. I become a member of Afeniferi because of my perception of that group.
So any Yoruba person can say, I want to be Afeniferi member?
Yes, it's open to everybody, particularly the younger generations. It used to be retired, palm set, and others, so what we have broadened it now. We want younger elements to join. And that's why they make me the coordinator in Osun State here. And I've been going around telling our people that in their own interest, let's join in something. It is not necessary that if you are, unless you are APC, you join. You
can. It's open to everybody.
Open to everybody.
Okay. Hello. Good evening. Okay, can we quickly have you?
Okay, How many traditional lives of Yoruba men enjoy our occasion and our culture?
Again?
I mean, how many traditional lives of Yoruba
endorsed what?
Okay.
How many traditional rulers are endorsed Senator Ayofasami as a leader of Afenifere?
I do not see how traditional requirement of
traditional rulers in the endorsement of Afenifere.
I do not see any. The traditional rulers, they themselves, they know they are Yoruba. And they want progress for the Yoruba.
Do they have input into...
Well, sometimes they offer suggestions.
Okay.
What they want. You know, this. In fact, I was going to Abuja to see the president. Part of the prompting
was
from the traditional rulers.
Let's check what at this last call. Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Hello, good evening. Can we have you, please? Okay, thanks. That's a young star there. Okay. A younger chap.
You say he's fine.
He's saying he's fine. Maybe. For whatever that must have meant. But it's an indication that the young will also grow.
Yes.
He was so tender an age.
Yes.
He wants to take part in the program. After time fast, but I want to appreciate you, Baba.
Thank you
for being with us on this program.
I'm very happy.
We hope to keep having more of you.
Thank you.
In this and years ahead.
Okay.
We wish Afenifere well.
Thank you.
Whether Faction A or Faction B.
Yeah, thank you.
And we wish Yoruba land well.
Thank you, sir.
To our viewers, thanks for being there. To all those who have called, we appreciate you. To those who are still calling, sorry, we can't take more call. Until next week, we will bring another personality on Let's Discuss. My name is Akinola Olabi. It's bye-bye for now.